We have discussed about what problems are faced by the patients of achalasia cardia, the basic understanding about this problem, and the tests that are needed for diagnosis of achalasia in our previous video. Now we are continuing on the discussion about the treatment options in achalasia cardia. Regarding treatment, we must understand that none of the treatment options are expected to stop or restore the loss of nerve fibers in your food pipe or esophagus. Also, none of the treatment options are likely to restore the normal peristalsis of the wall of your food pipe or the esophagus. All the treatment options aim at relaxing or weakening of the LES valve, that is the lower esophageal sphincter, to the point that it no longer poses a barrier to the passage of food. Thus, the food will pass down your food pipe with the help of gravity, and without the resistance of the LES valve, will easily pass to the stomach. Overall, the treatment options are surgical and non-surgical. The surgical treatment options are much more effective in improving the symptoms of the patients over a longer period of time. Let us first talk about the non-surgical options. The non-surgical options includes medication, endoscopic injection of Botox in the LES valve, and endoscopic pneumatic balloon dilatation. We are not going to discuss about medications and Botox injections because they are not very effective and are rarely advised to patients. So the truly available non-surgical option is endoscopic pneumatic balloon dilatation. This is an endoscopic procedure in which, with the help of an endoscope, a balloon is inserted into your food pipe and is inflated at the level of the LES valve to tear the sphincter muscles and keep the valve open. This is a crude and an inaccurate method of opening of the valve, and hence the results are inferior compared to the surgical options. There is also the chance of perforation or making a hole in the food pipe during this procedure. The chances of these complications occurring are 2-4%. And may need an emergency surgery to fix it up. Also, as this procedure does not include an anti-reflux measure, there are high chances that an acid reflux will develop after this procedure once the valve is open and may cause heartburn and reflux problems. Surgical treatment options. The surgical treatment options are more effective with very good long-term results. In the surgical options, the muscles of the LES valve are systematically divided under vision and hence the better outcomes. The surgical options include a laparoscopic surgery and an endoscopic surgery. Let's discuss each one of them in detail one by one. The laparoscopic surgery, which is called a laparoscopic Heller's cardiomyotomy with a door or a toupee fundoplication. Laparoscopy means a camera called laparoscope and other instruments are inserted in your tummy through small cuts in your tummy wall, and the surgery is performed. The surgeon divides the muscles of the lower esophageal sphincter, that is the LES valve, systematically under vision and keeps the valve open. Hence, the food can pass easily from the food pipe to the stomach. In cases where, while dividing the muscles of the LES valve, there is an accidental injury to the inner layer of the food pipe called the mucosa, it is repaired then and there without any compromise in the overall outcome of the surgery. At the end of the surgery, an endoscopy is done to check and confirm that the opening of the valve is adequate and that there is no accidental injury to the inner layer called mucosa which has gone unnoticed. Finally, once the muscles of the LES valve has been opened, the surgeon will fix the upper part of your stomach to the divided part of the LES valve and to the hiatus. This is called a door fundoplication and it is done to prevent the reflux of food and acid from the stomach back to the food pipe, which normally happens when the valve is open and kept open by dividing the muscles of the valve. Outcomes of laparoscopic surgery. Liquids are started few hours after surgery, followed by soft diet. Most of the patients are out of bed and moving around and walking within few hours after surgery and are discharged on the next day. Patients in whom there has been an accidental injury to the inner mucosal layer and has been repaired during the surgery, diet and discharge can be delayed by 1 or 2 days. Normal diet can be resumed within a week's time, but you should make sure that you chew your food properly while eating and eat slowly in a sitting position. Laparoscopic surgery gives excellent long-term outcomes. About 70 to 90% of patients have good symptom relief over a long period of time. The outcome of laparoscopic surgery depends upon the type of achalasia, which is defined by an esophageal manometry, and also on the amount of dilatation of your food pipe, which is shown in the barium dye study done before surgery. The results of surgery are better when the surgery is done earlier compared to the cases that are ignored and neglected, where the food pipe is significantly dilated and enlarged. As a door fundoplication is done in a laparoscopic surgery, the chances of acid reflux after surgery are also significantly less. Endoscopic surgery, called peroral endoscopic myotomy, very popularly known as POEM procedure. In this surgery, endoscope and the endoscopic instruments are passed from your mouth and throat to the food pipe or esophagus. The surgeon, with the help of specialized endoscopic instruments, creates an incision, that is a cut in the innermost lining of your food pipe called mucosa. Then, just like in a Heller's cardiomyotomy, the muscles of the lower part of your food pipe and the LES valve are divided under vision. At the end, the incision and cut in the mucosa is closed with the help of endoscopic clips. The resolution of symptoms are comparable to the laparoscopic surgery, and this procedure have shown very good short-term results. We must understand that the procedure is comparatively newer and hence the very long-term outcomes are yet to be seen. The main disadvantage of the endoscopic procedure is that it doesn't include an anti-reflux measure, that is the fundoplication. Hence, the chances of acid reflux after this endoscopic surgery are comparatively higher, in range of 40 to 60%. Patients who develop acid reflux after surgery would need antacid medications for a longer period of time. Follow-up after surgery. Since none of the treatment options of achalasia cures the underlying disease process, and because there are higher chances of cancer of esophagus in achalasia patients, a good long-term follow-up is very, very important. The goal in follow-up is to diagnose and treat the recurrence of symptoms and complications, especially acid reflux. Hope this video has helped you understand the different options of treatment of achalasia cardia. For any further queries or concerns, you can call us or send your reports on WhatsApp or email us.